Talking about CIPLA, Anuj was just mentioning that the earnings disappointment has come through, and to make matters worse, the management laid out a very challenging outlook for the second half. My colleague Ekta caught up with Umang Vohra, the MD and Global CEO, to talk about exactly this, the guidance for the rest of FY19 and the challenges that lie ahead. Listen in.
I think if you look at a set of numbers, yes, they're modest. They're modest because the last year had a huge amount of GST restocking, right? And we don't have that amount in this year. We've had a really bad season in India, which is very good for patients because there have been a fewer number who've fallen sick, which is excellent. But that impacts our numbers as well. So if you add this, I'm not so sure that I'm terribly troubled about where our business is headed. And we've come in with 18.8% of EBITDA. So the number trajectory is not all that bad. It's just slightly lower, but then our R&D is about 1.5% higher. See, the headwinds are more in terms of things that we don't control in our business. What we control in our business, we're fully in control of. We can't control a funding environment for tenders. And tenders are about 20-25% of our business. And as a result of that, if there's any impact on that, that's going to impact our business. And some of our tender businesses are growing at 40% lower versus the previous year. And it's very difficult to make up that shortfall in your overall business. And then there's the trajectory of volatility in terms of forex, commodity prices. And then, of course, there's sanctioned countries. And these are countries around sanctioned countries where there are issues on liquidity and things like that. So it's a mix of all of this, right? And therefore, we've just thrown a little bit of caution out there saying that, look, we are operating in an uncertain time. We're doing the best in markets that we can execute, right? India, private market growth, very strong. South Africa, very strong. US launch momentum is picking up, right? We're about 8% up. But there's 20-25% of our business, which... you know, we're getting hit by factors that we can't control. So that's the reason for the caution.
So the tender business, how much was it down by this quarter? And by that, you mean Africa mainly in terms of the tender business HIV tenders, etc. So how much was it down this quarter? And what is your outlook, say, for the next two quarters?
So if you look at our total tender businesses, the global access business that we run is about $150 to $200 million business per year. Annually, that business is down by about 40%+, right? The South Africa tender business last quarter, and not so much quarter one, but more in quarter two, is down by about 25%. So if you take an aggregate, our tender businesses in the last quarter that we've reported are down close to 30%, right? And on a revenue base, which could be closer to, let's say, about 100 odd million, for the quarter, 30% is $30 million. And not all of these tenders are low margin, right? Some of these tenders have reasonably good margins. And as a result of that, our overall business gets impacted, right? And that's the impact we've seen in our financials for this quarter. And it's quite likely the way we see the markets now that this might continue another quarter or so.
What about the other markets? Let's talk about the U.S. You had a couple of key product launches. How did they do, and what's your guidance for the US?
So it's interesting. We've guided to about 125 per quarter exit rate.
Yeah.
Right? We're at about 108. We were about 100 last quarter, so we've inched up by about $8 million. Our DTM business is building nice and strong. We've actually built a business almost worth $200 million over the last 2 years. Add that to Invagen, which is about $200. We already have a $500 million business in the US. Our B2B business is declining, and that's by design, because if we go DTM, we can't really be too much of a bigger B2B player. So I think the US commentary is good. Seven launches in the last quarter. Some of the result of that will play out in quarter three. Some will begin to play out in quarter four, right? So I think we're still guiding to 125 exit in quarter four and looking forward to getting there.
With some limited competition drug launch per quarter?
Yes. So we're still giving the same guidance that we hope to launch one limited competition product every quarter. I think the last quarter we had maybe more than one, about 2 to 3. And we're still very excited about the inhaler opportunity. I think that opportunity, when it begins to come in, let's say 9 months or 12 months from now, from then on, we'll have one inhaler launch in the US every year. And that's really where, you know, what CIPLA can bring to the U.S. market, and we're very positive about that.
What about India? That was flat this quarter. There might have been a GST restocking impact this time round. But X of that, what is your guidance, say, for the next 2 to 3 quarters?
So I'll say the full year guidance for India. Let me start with the full year guidance for India. We're still saying it's about 13-14%, thereabouts, right? I think we've seen a flattish quarter two. We saw 23-odd% in quarter one. So we are averaging half one at about 12%, adjusted for GST and things like that. So I'd like to believe that India will continue to see a 13-14% growth. Our quarter threes of the previous year again had some restocking, right? So I don't think we'll show a huge growth in quarter three, but I believe in quarter four we'll show a much higher growth. So overall for the year, about 13-14%. Quarter two, you're right, quarter two, the quarter that we reported, had the GST-led restocking. That's about, I'd like to believe that's about 10% or so of our numbers in India. And then we had a bad season, or a very low season. So that's another, that I'd like to believe is another 70-80 crores. So cumulatively, India had the impact of last year's base. That itself is about 170-180 odd crores.
Margins, they fluctuated between this band of say 17-19 odd percent for the past couple of quarters. Where are you probably going to sustain now?
I'd like to say we're going to sustain margins in the 18-19.5 range.
For the next?
For the next, well, at least let's talk about the next quarter, and then let's talk. The quarter four is a bad quarter to compare because India basically dies out on seasonality. So our margins always are lower in quarter four. But on a steady state basis, I think CIPLA in the range of 18-19.5, we're quite okay with that.
Okay, 18-19% is what he's expecting in terms of margins. But the stock has remained depressed since the numbers. We'll take a break on that note. Nothing depressing about the markets at all. Still doing very well, almost reaching out to 10,600. We'll come back and we're going to get a global voice. Pick days, Prashant Kothari joins us in a bit. Just stay tuned.
I would like to take this opportunity to wish each and every one of your viewers a very happy Diwali and an extremely happy New Year.